Too soon.
Guys.
Too soon.
Can we talk about the
I'm sure we can talk about the elephant room. Did you guys step on wires as you came on set? Talk to me again, you two. I can't hear you two now.
We're having some technical
issues. We'll get those tech issues worked out, but I don't care about this anyway, because as long as I've got Chuck, we're okay.
Me and I should Chuck never have gotten that close to you.
Jerome
You're Fult. All excited about it now.
He designed this guy, right?
Wait till I start rubbing. Oh, there we go. Mics are back.
We're back. Sorry about that, guys.
Don't be sorry. They can wait. It's no problem. They're used to it. It's how it goes. Waiter.
Okay, Hindu man.
So new god is out.
We made a Hindu. We made a Hindu god.
We made a Hindu god, finally.
You are the Hindu man.
It is. What is it?
I believe it's Ganesh.
It's an elephant.
I don't care. I know it's Ganesh.
Ganesh.
We leaked it last
Ganesh.
Time. What role is it?
Oh, well, in that case, I think we should probably do another Guardian.
Yeah, he's an assassin.
Probably.
Look at him.
He's an assassin.
Yeah, he's got that.
He's
like,
so fast and has his hit points
kinda
are so
like
small.
Kind of like Liam Neeson from Taken is his fighting style. So
I'd have been sold if it was an assassin just to see the troll of everybody going, what really is an assassin?
I'll put that on the list. Giant, bulky
assassin. Huge
assassin. For the future.
With stealth.
I'm sure there will be no visual confusion there.
Kabrakan.
Sure. So let's start things off the right way.
Fishman, Loki.
Tell me a little bit about the lore of Ganesh and why he's joined the background.
So,
or she.
The interesting thing about the Hindu pantheon is that it is a living religion, right? A lot of these are things that, you know, ancestors in different parts of the world worshipped, but this is something that still worships today. And in fact, Ganesh is so widely worshipped that he, kind of like Robin Hood or King Arthur, has various versions of all of his stories, because there's just so many people who follow Ganesh. But one of the versions is that you have Shiva and you have his wife Parvati. And she's taking a bath, and Shiva comes and is like, hey, oh, hey, we got to talk or whatever. She's like, how are you just coming in here when I'm taking a bath? That's weird. And so she sculpts him out of clay, this child of hers, without telling Shiva. So the next time Shiva comes up and he sees this strange man standing outside of the room where his wife is bathing, and he's like, she might be in trouble. Who are you? And of course, neither of them recognize each other.
Sure.
So he, Ganesh has this cane, and he like tries to beat Shiva away with the cane. He's like, don't come in here. My mama's in there. She's taking a bath. She doesn't want to see people right now. But
okay.
Shiva's like, that's my wife. I don't know who you are. You're kind of creeping me out. So he gets some gods and some demons. He's like, we're going to take this guy out. I'm going to go make sure my wife's okay. Meanwhile, clearly
the whole
communication
time she's just taking a
is
bath,
the key.
Right?
The
and he's like, I'm
going to
go get some gods and demons. I'm coming right back
to any relationship.
Listen
so
to
she's like, oh, how am I
going to
deal with this? I'm going to get you two backup goddesses. They're going to make you invulnerable. So Ganesh goes out there, and he's going to defend her. And then Shiva sends his gods and demons to go get him out. And then he distracts the two goddesses. And like, oh, hey, look over there. And then cuts off Ganesh's head. And then Parvati's like, that is our son. You just killed him. Fix this. You better make this right, or you're sleeping on the couch forever. So he finds the wisest creature in the area, which is an elephant, and he takes its head, and he puts it on top of Ganesh.
And that's how the elephant got in the room.
Sure. Sure.
By being... No, I'm not even...
And then Ram actually comes up and does the same kind of thing, where he's like, oh, hey, I want to go talk to Shiva.
Yeah.
And you know, Ganesh, he's a god of barriers and obstacles. And he's like, I'm the obstacle. You're not getting in there to see him. Do you have an appointment? And Ram's like, do you know who I am? He's like, I know you're not getting in here. That's who I know you are. So they fight, and he loses a tusk.
Oh.
Highlighted there.
Tusk.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Talk to me about the card art and talk about the art where they went into this then, Chuck. Because obviously it is a living religion, right? So we always take that into account as well.
It is. It was a very interesting challenge because we wanted to be kind of true to the lore and true to the imagery. But there's such a wide variety of imagery for this character. There's very feminine kind of cartoony-ish versions. There's, you know, there's very kind of the statue versions are very like intense and kind of reverential. So we're trying to mix a lot of those things. We want him to feel very wise and benefactory while also feeling like a big, tough elephant dude because, you know, he's a guardian.
He's also been worshipped a long time, too. So like the art has progressed from like very early art to much more modern art.
And it's really all over the place. And we tried to reflect that in the recolor, which you'll see later.
Oh, we got a recolor for later, huh?
Oh, yeah.
I'm excited.
It's a very interesting recolor.
Is it?
Lore accurate.
Well, you had a little look at this last patch notes when Pom Pom, as usual, messed up with Fat Odin. But it's not Fat Odin, it's Ganesh. Is that a bowl of fruit?
Yes.
Of sweets.
Yeah.
A bowl of treats. It's very important to his
all the symbols.
Symbols.
Excited about them. We're all happy about it. We get to run at people and go, come here, I've got candy. It's great. Here, take my candy. It's great.
And he's got the lotus and the goad in his broken tusk.
That's right.
You want to talk about each of those?
Which he uses to open
envelopes.
Yeah, please
do.
Yeah, go over those symbols real quick.
Let's go, Chuck.
Yeah, captive audience.
The lore master fish.
I mean, the lotus flower has a lot of symbolism in not just Hindu, but several mythologies. Mm. And then there's also kind of similar to Kali, when you've got these arms, a lot of times what they're representing is dualities or variations on the things that they can provide, like a good or an evil. He's normally good, but he could be like a passive or a protector kind of violent thing with the goad. The goad is kind of, pushing you on the path. Since he is the god of obstacles, originally, there's some like very concrete symbolism with him blocking the way into these rooms. But over time, that's become a metaphorical obstacle. It's like, oh, I'm going to remove your barriers to success.
Gotcha.
I'm going to become a god of wealth, a god of success. And kind of all that is represented by him. So, of course, he's got four different arms with four different objects to kind of speak to those various.
Well, you talk about god of success and god of wealth. The passive of this godfish, which I'm going to come to you for fish,
sure.
is called god of fortune.
Good fortune.
Right, good fortune.
He is a god of fortune. But
he
this is
a god of fortune.
Good fortune.
Good fortune. What does this passive mean?
So this is...
Oh, change. What's that? Whoa.
That's exactly... That's what we're looking at here is the passive. So when he stands far back by himself...
Right.
Which is the opposite of what he's doing now. Thanks,
so,
Bond.
The elephant comes up.
He's going to see his own face, and it's not glowing. It's not lit up. And what that is it's indicating his assist radius.
Okay.
If he gets closer to one of his allies, it's going to light up and show you that he's going to get assist credit from any kills that are in this range. That's the same as any god normally would.
Sure.
Except that if he gets a kill, he's not going to take credit for that kill. His ally, who's in that assist radius, as indicated by the passive meter, is going to get the kill credit, and he's going to get the assist.
Oh.
Because he's delivering kill That's bestowed.
Right. He's removing success. The obstacles to his hunter's success, to his solo, his mid success.
So you can actually, go for the kill secure for your team
That's
and not
right.
worry about
you
stealing
You can hard commit,
carries.
And you will never steal if your ally is in correct range. And
gotcha.
Since that's probably going to take away from a little bit of his gold and a little bit of his experience from the assist credit instead of the kill credit, he gets an increased assist range to help with that. Most gods, it's going to be 80 feet, and they're going to have 10 seconds after their last hit
right.
To get the assist credit. He's going to have 100 units and... 15 seconds.
Right.
So he should
gets
be getting
a bigger
more
assist range That's overall
right.
with this.
So if he wants to roam back and forth, he'll have a better chance of getting the assist credits from lane on the minions. He can last hit the wave, help his hunter clear, and he will never steal those kill credits. His hunter will always get those.
Just
kind of making your job, removing barriers from your support play.
Last hitting the wave is a really nice kind of quality of life thing as a guardian. You can the wave can be almost low, almost dead, and your ability can come up cooldown. You can just clear it. As long as your hunter is there, everything will be nice and divvied up as you'd hope, as if you were min-maxing perfectly. If you're alone, he can, of course, get the last hits like he normally would, but as long as someone's nearby, he donates.
Whoa, you blew my mind then. Wait, it's not just on god kills, it's also on minion kills?
That's right.
Yes. That's right.
On minion kills too?
Yep.
Yes.
So
and just
stacks,
I know people are going to ask this.
What sure. stacks? That's the question, though. What
He'll get assist stacks, and his ally will get kill stacks.
Do if the hunter get stacks of their, transcendence and things?
They will?
Yes.
Okay. Shibalanke will get stacks of his passive.
Mr. Jibble?
Kill someone.
Kali will refresh based on her passive
if
he kills
her
target.
Thanatos. It works through the kill logic.
I'm not the one on the patch notes to say swear words, but well, shit. That sounds pretty good, actually.
Yeah, well, team is not here, so you get one.
Yeah, I had
you
to
get
one.
And just because I know people are going to ask this, the way it decides who gets it if you have multiple allies, it's the one who's closest to Ganesh.
Right, okay. So if you have a hunter and an assassin fighting with Ganesh, if Ganesh is close to the assassin gets another hunter.
That's right.
And Makes Ganesh sense. Gets the kill. Rare scenario, but of course, we got it covered.
Okay. Now check out when his flower and his sweets reappear. It's amazing.
God, let's wait for the sweeties.
Just gonna pull them out like a gentleman.
Whenever you watch, it feels like forever. But
Slowly
when you're playing,
for the
it happens
economy.
All the time. Make sure you don't do anything, Pawn.
Nothing.
That's dope.
Nice. That was pretty cool.
That was worth waiting for.
Yeah.
I was like,
See?
Is this one of those Chuck things again where we sit and look at a cloak that doesn't do anything different?
Oh, man.
You were a 3D artist. You appreciate it.
I'm sorry. I'm just...
You guys are just going at it today. Never put these two next to each other on the show.
We've always next to each other.
They have a good
feral. We just got closer. That's the only thing. With more and more episodes. But earlier on, Pompon showed ability 1 for us, which is called Turn of Fate. AJ, what exactly does this do?
Right. So this is a line projectile. Passes through targets, dealing damage. And it has a unique little, you know, kind of a balance feature here where if it hits enemies, right, for every enemy hit up to five, it emanates out a buff to Ganesh's allies.
Which we can see on Odin
there. Right, you can see on that Odin right there. This is a really cool thing because we don't really have a projectile that has buffs and damage to allies in the same kind of configuration as this.
Yeah.
It really incentivizes you as Ganesh to hit a bunch of targets and spoil abilities that we're not talking about yet. It really incentivizes you to hit a bunch of targets with this.
Pop sounds to move it along.
It's got a big radius, too, for the buff radius, so right, it's you shouldn't really have to worry about kind of tiptoeing on that line. Like, if you're in lane with Ganesh, you'll be getting this buff, and it'll help you lane clear a lot as well. So if you Ganesh one first,
yeah,
and then your hunter can follow right up, you're going to get a big damage spike there, because the buff is actually quite significant up to, remind me the number
exactly. I'm going to have bonus damage per stack 2%.
So up to 10%, that's damage percent, which is very strong, you know, and it's not power, it's actual damage 10% more if you're fully buffed by
Ganesh. It's on god hits, or?
It's on all hits.
Triggers
buff to out. Yeah, you clear the wave, get the damage.
So as long as it hits targets, it gives the buff out to your team is at nearby.
It is a relatively short duration buff, so this is not like you can just walk around forever enjoying this. You need to kind of coordinate with your Ganesh when you're playing with him to get this to max out of it.
But if your
really
teammate
fun.
Is going in hard early, you now can shoot it down the minion wave.
Yep.
Well, that's ability one, which is called Turn of Fate, as long as Pompon stops trying to kill people.
The range on that is 55, which is if your allies are in range of a basic attack, or if your allies are in range of the smaller two, which we're about to see, they're definitely in range of the buff.
Speaking of the two, it's called Ohm.
Yeah, guess what that does.
I'm guessing he does something where, let me guess, he does that because Pompon keeps leaking it.
That's right.
What does that do exactly, Fisher?
So he's speaking the universal syllable. And what he's doing is he's being nonviolent here. He is, that circle is indicating that the radius at which his allies gain protections, pretty substantial protections at rank 5. And that cone that you see in the center there is
that?
What his enemies have to worry about. While they're in that, they are continuously silenced.
Whoa.
So this is some pretty serious lockdown.
Yes.
You're shutting down enemy abilities with the silence, and you're shutting down enemy basic attacks from hunters and assassins with the protection buff.
So the area all the way around that circle you see is protection for your team.
That's
and
right.
That tiny little cone in the middle is where all the silence is.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Gotcha.
And from an enemy team, you'll get some, you know, the friendly enemy type of effects, which will make it clear that the cone is what you're concerned about as an enemy, and the circle is a lot more dim.
It makes sense.
You won't even see the circle.
Yeah, you won't even see the circle, yeah. Because this clear. That Ganesh is the one silencing you with this.
Pretty
cone.
Good for engaging or disengaging your teammates as well, buffing them at the same time as trying to stop people on heal. So,
however, also it is short-lived, and he can't do anything else during that.
That's true.
It's a channeled ability,
and he can be interrupted out of it, like with the Ymir freeze.
Right.
So
you got to sneak up behind
do it
him
before
though.
He can turn around and go no.
Yeah. If you're quick on your camera, you can interrupt a lot of stuff with this.
I'm looking forward to skins for this god already with some of these ability names. Next up is the ability 3, which AJ, would you like to talk us through? It's called Remove Obstacles. I guess things move out of the way.
Well, you'd think that, but it does a lot of other things.
Okay.
And we'll get to that part later.
It's a dash.
So this is a dash. Yeah, this is a straight line dash that's going to collide with any god's hit, and it's going to pass through minions.
Man, I love that sound.
I love the sound and the animation. The screen actually shakes a little bit to really get you that elephant, stampede charge feel. So if you hit a god with this, it's going to do a little grab animation here, which is a stun into a knock-up. So let's get someone out in the open so we can see. So you get
punches him 3 times and then throws him in the air.
A big creature elephant with these big arms. We wanted something where he was really using them. So you dash up to an enemy god, it's gonna stun them briefly, hit them twice, and then throw them up in the air, which is so technically three hits of damage.
And a knockup as well.
And they only go straight up. It's not a Mercury style.
It's a straight up
action.
But it's really good for like comboing with a Willix. You can see very clearly when it's going to throw up.
Ohm as well.
Warns you. Yeah, so Ganesh is really good at locking down a single enemy god with his 3-2 combo. If you go into that, you get a tough time getting away from him.
Okay. So that ability as
well.
But he
definitely needs somebody to follow up that
action. Oh, yeah.
Action.
I mean, he's very much a supporty guardian.
Now, I also understand this can go through player-made objects as well. Is that
correct? Exactly. That's what we're talking about, our obstacles. So actually, you can dash through Ymir Wall with this. You can get.
Does it break Ymir Wall?
It does not.
But you can go through it.
It lets him go through them.
What about Odin Ring? You can go through Odin Ring.
All player-made walls and blockers.
Oh,
so not her pillar.
Not walls on the map, but player-made walls.
Player-made walls he can go through.
Thor, Interesting.
To Bracken.
And we talked about smashing them, but the cooldown is... You can do this a lot.
And especially, like, if... Figuring out how to explain that it couldn't work on Odin, but could work on other ones if you could break it.
Sure.
Or, and not have him break an ultimate. So.
Smashing Odin wall is really pretty rough on balance.
Remove the obstacle of the enemy god.
That'd
pass
be a
through the
hard
obstacle
counter.
Of the wall.
Yeah. Hard counter. So he can just use it to go through them, which is nice in, you know, certain scenarios, but not necessarily something you want to pick him for directly. Maybe, though.
Well, I've lost the last page of my book, so I don't know what the fourth ability is called.
Well, it's pretty...
Fishman, why don't you tell me?
I believe it's the Dharmic Pillars.
The Dharmic Pillars.
That's right.
I've seen this before somewhere.
This might look familiar if you were an old school Smite player.
Did we rip it off from another game?
No.
Oh.
Maybe.
Or was it Nuwa?
From Global Agenda, I believe.
AKA Oldwa.
Is that what I think he's going to do? Oh my god!
Sure.
Is Shake and Bake back?
Is Shake and Bake.
So let's talk about Shake and Bake. Shake and Bake was one of the issues with the original
Oldwa
ult.
Let's talk about baking and shaking.
Is when they first did the Nuwa ultimate, she could cast out the pillars with these lines, and anybody who was on them would take damage. And so what you'd do is you'd have Fenrir go grab somebody and just wiggle the mouse in and out of those lines, and it would apply damage every time they came in contact with it. And we actually solved this on the Oldwa ultimate by making it so that it couldn't apply more than once every X seconds.
Okay.
And we kept that fix here. So no matter how you wiggle your mouse with a Fenrir, they're still...
You're on counter.
Don't get us wrong. That is a very strong ultimate synergy, but there are tons of those in the game. It's not like it's game-breaking anymore. It doesn't do an absurd amount of damage, but it does do a lot.
Sure.
If you're going to invest two ultimates on the player anyway, there's a lot that can be equally potent. So.
If you can lock someone in here for the full 6 seconds, they will take a lot of damage. It's more likely that they'll pass through it once if you cast it around them,
okay.
Or maybe twice if you put it in such a way that they have to cross a corner. And you can actually combo it with some of your other lockdown if so they're on it.
And it looks just easy on an Odin that isn't moving.
Yeah.
But in practice...
Sure. It's much easier if you get a teammate to lock them down beforehand, then you cast it onto them while they're still, and then you can follow up with your three. Trying to land the old three combo by yourself is very tricky.
So we see it does damage, but it does more than does damage.
That's
correct.
Right. Passing through it, nothing happens in the center, but when you pass through it...
Just the lines.
The lines, that's right. So the four outer pillars are blockers. And if you pass through those energy lines in between them, you take the damage for as long as you're on there, every half second. You are also slowed for 3 seconds, and your protections are shredded for 3 seconds.
Okay.
So between this and the one, you can substantially increase the damage that your team is doing to these guys.
But you can leap out of it.
Sure.
And not take any of that.
That's right.
I just want to make sure for the Vanzar, so you can just leap out, but... If you go past through that, you're going to take Protection Shred, a slow, and damage.
That's right.
Ooh. Welcome back. I missed that ability, to be fair.
Yeah, the pillars. The pillars have returned. It's one that we've always heard from our fans and people who've played Smite for a long time that wanted it back. So with the god who's creating and removing obstacles, it's like that just made so much sense.
The most unique obstacle we may have ever
had.
And
a nice zoning ability makes sense for a guardian. It's working out well.
Man, I love the sound design on this guy.
The sound
design.
Yeah,
they did a really good job.
I love the wub-wubs on the ultimate.
Yeah. And I love the charge noise.
I'm a pump on showing you guys that those pillars are actually hard objects right now.
But
if you walk against Bob, because he's got his three, he can
go through
all those obstacles.
Mm-hmm. Can we do a couple basics, like a full rotation? So what you'll see is he's actually got... He smacks him with his trunk.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't do any...
Hit chain, right, Fish?
That's right.
It's a very interesting hit chain for a guardian, too, which is just fun.
And it ends on the trunk swap, so...
The more you know, you just see him dancing in and out of radius as well. What fun have you had with him in playtest? Is he designed to be a supportive guardian, or can he solo? Can he jungle?
Sure. So two gods ago, we had Kuzumbo.
Yes.
And he was a much more aggressive, in-your-face, like solo lane even guardian. So when we do them this close together, we want to very distinctly differentiate them. So where Kuzumbo is all about like moving you, displacing you, Ganesh wants to keep you in place. Ganesh wants to lock you down, and Ganesh wants to let his teammates do most of the job. And this kid is kind of built around that. The most fun we had was with the knock up into the silence combo, getting that feeling right. And particularly before it was balanced a little bit down to where it is currently, that was really strong and felt really good.
So the knock up on that as well, because obviously it's a stun first, but how large is the knock up? It looks a little bit bigger than Geb's too, but a little bit.
It's around the same ballpark. It's shorter than most of our knock ups, but it's in that Geb range where it's going to keep him. It's going to keep him in that spot, but it's not going to keep him out of the play space for very long at all.
Popeye's just getting as many pendant kills as he can. And
sure.
Actually, he's giving assist to the Odin to get those pendant kills. Look at Pendant.
Odin wasn't to level close enough for now.
That one's got to level 6. Range.
Yeah.
Just so you know, that's how
sure.
much he's leveling.
Ganesh
up.
Can level his bots.
So there's level 7, yep.
So you really, truly
Odin
can
has a
potentially carry your team with this god by giving them kills.
Sure.
That's actually pretty good. Really, really cool. Any other interesting facts or things that we never saw in this that you tried to work or anything like that?
Well, we definitely tried, like, him taking damage instead of his allies.
Oh.
And that was super strong. Because he would build Meditate and Undo. Mm-hmm. And then he would keep one of his allies from dying, and he just wouldn't care because he had a bunch of health and Meditate and Undo. So
Pain Split, harder to do than it sounds.
Yeah.
We tried a lot of variations on the 1 and the 2 with slightly differing effects. You know, yeah. I'm really happy with how we ended up with the 1. With the it's incentivized to hit multiple targets, but mm-hmm. you get a ally team buff off of it. And it's an aggressive buff, not like a protections or a heal or something like that, which is just a really unique dynamic for a Guardian ability that's seems simple on the surface, but has a lot of different implications on how you use it and how your teammates can make the best of it, which is just really fun when we're getting deeper into the God roster.
And it also, like, it looks like some of our other projectiles as far as the way it presents, but its range is actually a little bit shorter, and between that and the 2, it kind of encourages for him to be at the front of his team and right up next to the enemy.
Yeah, that was one thing we agreed on pretty early on, Ganesh. We wanted him up in the fight, too.
Right.
Like, although he's a very supportive Guardian, we didn't want him, like, backline Geb, yeah. like, peeling and Kepri.
So
we
like
wanted him
Kabrakan sort of style in your face. Sort of.
Yeah, but a more protective supporty, which is a pretty unique...
Gotcha.
Role for a Guardian in
sure.
Smite.
Sure.
I'm just really happy with the way he turned out, like his art and his sounds.
Looks
like,
amazing.
Yeah.
We'll talk about the art a little bit more because I know Chuck really wanted to harp on this.
Hold on, I have a question.
Here we go. I was actually setting you up to do what you wanted, you know. So.
Do we think the reason that Chad thinks things are OP is because Pawn kills 50 Odins that are level 1 while he's level 20 in the map?
Maybe
I'm
they just know how good Pawn is.
For this whole thing.
That's actually where I made the comment earlier about the level 20 Scylla not doing any damage to Odin, is because this is a very conspicuous testing ground. It's just for the convenience of us demonstrating stuff. It's not at all representative of their actual power.
Oh, no, don't do this.
No, we're going to see what full power Ganesh looks like.
Yeah, I think so.
I believe Pawn...
You did this. You did this.
But it's level 1 Odin's, so...
No.
Prove my point, Pawn. Let's do it.
A
prove
fly
my
could
point.
Sneeze, and they'd die anyway. So I definitely think we have some people who, if you're doing something else while you're watching the stream, it comes off like that, but I think we try to communicate... This is the testing scenario.
Hey, Pawn tried to play some damage Ganesh yesterday. It was not as successful as the support Ganesh. Although Pawn will carry you, but
we'll go back
I don't
to
know
the,
if damage Ganesh is the way
the
to
side,
do it.
Yeah.
Back towards the art again, though. I believe Chuck did say something about a recall of the
Wait,
movie
we didn't listen
to
the voice pack yet.
Oh, you want the voice pack first? All right, fine. You don't get the recall then.
No, we have to do both.
Well, he's going
to
ask for the recolor while you're listening to the voice
pack. Calling the shots now?
I am now. I always have been. Just because you guys need to be more comfortable all of a sudden. You
didn't think.
All right, I feel like we could override you in a vote.
Oh, yeah, we do outnumber you.
I can just pull the plug on the show. It's not average.
Yeah, that doesn't mean you're in charge. That means you're going
to
jail.
No, I know.
Who wants to hear the voice pack and then do the recolor? I thought AJ was just going to leave me hanging there for a second.
Importantly,
I was just mesmerized
production
by his
is spoken
recall.
Over the headsets that's what we're going to do, and that's the vote that really matters.
I'm just waiting for you to all shut up so we can hear the voice pack if you want to hear it so bad.
Contemplate silence. You are the universe. How fortunate. I am the great god at the gate.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
That's not going to get spammed.
That's a top tier woohoo.
When you're the only obstacle to my victory, it is assured. If you've deluded yourself into thinking you can stop me, you are mistaken. This is a battle I'll never forget. I don't like any barriers between myself and a vacation. That's why I always pack my Trump.
Oh, God.
We've got to have one. Got to have one. I love his taunt animation, too. He takes his bowl of treats and just transfers which hand it's in and, like, offers it and then goes, no, and then he eats one.
No.
He's like,
no.
Yo, you want a treat? Psych.
I actually like the voice back as well because it kind of fits him into a regal sort of character.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We worked really hard to be sensitive to, like, since this is somebody that people actually worship, to do him justice and not be overly silly in a way that would be offensive, so...
Sure. Always the focus, especially with the active religions as well. Yeah. We do also have the recolor then, which I know Chuck was asking about because he wanted to talk about the recolor a little bit.
So you see...
I do see now.
There it is.
So see this...
It's pink!
Yes.
It's a pink elephant!
And, you know, do some Googling. Yeah. There is a lot. And when I pitched this in the modeling meeting, they were like, it can't be this pink. We're not going to, what is that?
I was there, and I was also shocked.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
I'll admit, I was against the pink.
I'm like, we're making him internet pink. We're doing it.
Yeah.
This is accurate in a lot of the imagery.
It's very accurate. Yeah. There is tons of imagery of him where he is. Intensely pink.
That looks
pink.
Dope. That
looks
really
cool.
It's amazing.
Cool.
It turned out amazing.
That looks really good. I like it.
All those treats seem a little spoiled.
Is that all you wanted to say? It's like, listen, pink is okay. Is that all you wanted to say? Pink is normal.
Yeah, I was
it is.
Yep, I was I want hot pink in the lows and bubblegum in the highs and a cyan off. Yeah. An orange transition.
It would have been fair to interpret.
I know Chad appreciates the detail that you're going into that.
I just had pink. I didn't know the other words that came out of his mouth after that. I just knew pink.
I mean, look at that.
I know the words. I just don't know what they refer to on a color scale.
It's a cool recolor.
It looks great.
Everyone did a great job. Simon did an amazing job. Animation
had to work double time on this guy.
Because he's got a lot of appendages.
Yeah, he's got twice the arms and a trunk.
On PTS is a final thing.
That's
a
Chris question. I think it's looking pretty good. I think we'll probably have PTS pretty soon. Keep an eye out for the Twitter. Usually High Res Chris on Twitter will give you that PTS info.
And this should be out next Tuesday as well.
Yeah, we'll see everybody playing with the summer split patch. Big balance, new god.
Mm-hmm.
Reset your ranks. A lot of changes. Ponpon did an amazing job with all those. So it's gonna be a good patch.
And that's pretty much all we've got time for then, I guess, if that's all there is to go through. Chuck, any final words?
Play a voice back, he'll talk.
Any final words?
Got him.
No? You good?
Got him.
Fishman?
Hope you enjoy him.
AJ?
Yeah. Play Ganesh.
And with that, I will close the show with saying updated the description of this ability with the correct range for this ability. We'll see you all next time on the Patch Note Show in 2 weeks.